Okay, good afternoon, Mr. Naris, and good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Tuan. It's a great thing. It's a great session again. Thank you once again for having me. And it's going to be an exciting session today. So I'm looking forward to go through the whole session with you, Tuan Haji.
Yeah, I see your slide. You have three interesting topics to share with our audience today.
Yep.
So before we start, maybe we can ask our audience where they have come from, which place, and maybe we would like to know lah, maybe from Geylang, from Jurong, or from Bukit Panjang, before we go on.
Yes, yeah. I'm interested to know also where are our audience watching this session from.
Mm-hmm.
That will be useful. It will give us more motivation to keep sharing and then to create this awareness.
In fact, they can tag to their friend so that everyone knows that we are having our seminar every Saturday.
Yes, exactly.
Maybe you can share. Okay, me Arya from Batu. Hello. Maybe we like to know address sheet. Reshin, I think, from Sabah, you know, from KK.
Ah, hi, yeah. Miss Grace.
Yeah, yeah. How are you, Grace? How are you, me Arya? Kalsum, hello, everyone, from CCK. You know CCK, right?
CCK is Choa Chu Kang.
Ah, Choa Chu Kang. Choa Chu Kang,
yeah. Hi, Miss Kalsum. Thanks for joining us.
Sumita, I think your wife, right? Sumita.
So my sister. I just thank my sister.
Okay, good. Yeah. Yeah, thank you, Sumita. Okay, sila tuan. Okay. So maybe if they have any question about public goal or anything about goal, they can comment here lah, so that we can answer one by one.
Exactly. Yeah, just feel free to drop your questions and then we will regularly look at the comment section and answer the questions accordingly. So no need to wait until the end of the session and all that. So just drop your questions and then either myself or Tuan Haji will look through the comment section and we will bring up the question as part of our discussion today.
Yeah. Okay. So can we start, Mr. Naris?
Yes, we can.
Okay. Today's topic, very interesting. In fact, this topic, a lot of people like to know why you keep goal. Why you keep goal?
Exactly, correct. They want to know what's in it for them. Why they need to spend the time? Why they need to waste the time, as they call it? So actually, we are not doing this for fun. There are actually very fundamental reason to it, which was something that we will go through in the next couple of minutes.
So before we go through. We like to ask our audience to support our YouTube channel, and our Facebook. Okay, they can like for Facebook or for YouTube. They can subscribe lah. Yep. My YouTube is under One Goldina, and my name itself. And for Mr. Naresh, I think you are using Diversify with Gold, correct, Mr. Naresh?
Yes, correct. Diversify with Gold. You can see the logo as stated. As can be seen as my backdrop, that is the logo for my page. So if you find a page with this logo, then that is the page I'm talking about. And that's where I continuously sharing about the benefits of gold and whatnot, similar to Tuan Haji.
Our topic is how to profit with gold. Yeah?
Yes. That is okay, also. Okay. So how what do you think about this topic, Tuan Haji? Maybe we can start with the topic itself.
This is the question that people would like to know. Why you are keeping gold? What is the profit and how much gold can give you profit a year? This is people look for.
Exactly. Correct? Yes, correct. Every time we talk about gold, the question they typically ask is that what is the profit potential of gold? Because at this age, there are so many financial tools out there. And I think maybe Tuan Haji also have heard the latest, the NFT, the non-fungible token. right? Where people are saving digital art in the form of a digital currency, and then they claim that also an asset. So people are comparing. Okay, so at this age, when the information is a lot out there, it's natural for people to know what is the comparison between one asset to another. So I think the topic today that we are going to cover will answer some of the questions that many of us are having in their mind.
First of all, we like to share because in fact, every week we are sharing the gold price of gold accumulation program that for public gold.
Right.
If you look at the price, first of January, New Year,
right.
New Year was Saturday, the day. So the price RM is 269 per gram. So if I convert to Sing dollar, it's around 89.66. So last week when I did it with Mr. Jalani, from Jalani, January, the price was 264 per gram. That means that the gold price is reducing.
Went down by 5 ringgit.
Yes. So the price is 88. In Sing dollar is 88 dollar, around $1 plus. $1 plus. So today, I just put a price here. Should I buy gold? So today, the price is 269, same as the 1st of January, 269.
Okay.
Which for in Sing dollar is 89.66.
Right, about 90 lah, $90 lah, more or less.
Yes.
So what is the lesson that we can learn from this gold price movement, Tuan Haji?
Meaning the price is sideways lah. Investor take a look. They don't decide whether to buy or to sell the gold. That's why next week maybe the price is around that. But for us, gold saver, we are our intention is we want to increase our holding of gold.
Correct.
That's why every month we are keeping buying, even though the price is high or the price is low. Mr. Narissa.
Yes, correct. I also look at the situation at the same way, where our role as gold, as a gold saver, which is one of the topic that we're going to cover later. Our role is to increase the grams of gold as the time progresses. So when we adopt that mindset, the price volatility is actually our friend, not our enemy. So that is why, first of all, we must understand, when we want to do this gold savings or gold investment, what is the mindset that we are adopting, right? So I think if you are ready, we can go to the next slide.
Okay, so maybe you can explain more about this.
Okay, so typically I would want to bring everybody on the same page, where we want to know why are we doing this in the first place. Recently, now we are in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic, right? And now the governments around the world are talking about considering COVID-19 as endemic, meaning it is something that is common. But then at the same time, when we were having this COVID-19 pandemic, we were given instruction that we need to get some form of protection. And that protection is the vaccine, right? Have you got your vaccine, Tuan Haji?
Yeah, for the third one, first and second already.
Okay. So the reason why we get ourselves vaccinated, so that we are not being affected severely when we fall sick due to COVID, should we get the virus in our body. So if our health is also protected using vaccine, the same is also true with our wealth or our finance. Right? So with finance, what happened is that we have this virus, right? We have this virus known as inflation. So inflation, to put it in simple terms, it refers to how the value of our money is getting lesser and lesser over time. And this is what we can see in the slide over here, where if you look at the picture of the US dollar, I put $100 over there. Perhaps Swanaji can press the next slide. I think I have converted the dollar into Ringgit Malaysia, but I think in this context, we can also look at it from a Singaporean dollar perspective,
yeah,
also.
Dollar,
yeah, from correct, a Sing dollar perspective also, because the same phenomena also happens with our Sing dollar also. And so what we can see over here is that as time progresses, the same value of money can be translated or can be converted into lesser and lesser number of items, which can be seen in the trolley in the picture. So when we get lesser and lesser items over the years, this simply means that the value of our money is reducing year after year. People, on the other hand, general public, they will say that, Naresh, we are getting less items because the price of goods have gone up, right? So price of goods have gone up, correct. But why is that happening? Why did the price of goods go up? Because the value of our money has gone down. So that is the other side of the equation that not many people are talking about, right? So here is where, when we look at the same conversion between our money and also gold, we can see that in the year 2000, with the same 100 ringgit, we can get about 3 grams of gold. And along the years, we can see that the same 100 ringgit will give us a lesser and lesser amount of gold. Perhaps Sonaji can go to the next slide. So here, if you see, some animation has taken place over here, if you look at the slide. So what has happened here? So here, we are just giving you a picture, a depiction that, let's say in the year 2000, our hard-earned money, our long-term savings, instead of keeping in the form of cash, if we convert them into gold, right? So previously we mentioned that 100 ringgit will give us 3 grams of gold. And let's say our long-term savings is kept in this form of asset, which is gold. So when we keep our long-term savings in the form of gold, over the years, as we convert them to get our goods and services, surprisingly, we would say that the amount of items that we receive will be almost the same. So for example, in the year 2000, the same 100 ringgit will give us 3 grams of gold. So today the same 3 grams of gold. So just now Tuan Haji has mentioned that 1 gram of gold is about 269 ringgit. So let's make it 270 lah. So 270 times 3, because we have 3 grams of gold, which we saved long time back, remember? So since we kept our long-term savings since the year 2000, today the same savings is now worth 270 times 3 is 810. Is that right?
Yes.
I think, yeah, it's 810. So ladies and gentlemen who are watching this webinar, let's say if I give to you a cash of 810 ringgit, do you think you can go to the nearest supermarket and get me one trolley of items like this? Yeah, the answer is most likely yes. Because when I give you 110 ringgit, which is equivalent to 3 grams of gold that is kept for a long time, you can get the same number of items. Unless, but let's say if the flip side of it, let's say if I give you 100 ringgit, if I give you 100 ringgit and ask you to go to the nearest supermarket and get me one trolley of items, the items would be lesser, as what we see in the previous slide. So that is the idea that I would like to bring forward to put everybody on the same page. So we are doing this gold savings and gold investment because we want to protect our long-term savings. Okay, so perhaps Sonaji, we can go to the next one.
Yeah, Mr. Naresh, what are you trying to say? If we are keeping gold, whatever we can buy 10 years back with the quantity of the gold, let's say 3 grand, we still buy the same stuff. We can
exactly
buy the same stuff, correct?
Exactly, yes, you got it absolutely correct, Tuan Haji. So which is why it is very important for us to take this action. I was just reading a post earlier today, Tuan Haji. It was written by Tuan Azizi Ali. So Tuan Azizi Ali is actually one of our financial expert in Malaysia, but I think even in the region, I would say. And he was putting a post on his Facebook page that The inflation rate in Malaysia was recorded at was reported to be 3.3%. And then I also did some searching to know what is the inflation rate of Singapore. So the inflation rate of Singapore is about 2.7%. And then the inflation rate of USA, the America, is 7.1%. So
wow,
here,
very
high, exactly. So here, what we can understand is that whether we like it or not, the inflation rate will keep on, whether high or low, the impact of inflation is that the value of our money is getting lesser and lesser. So, I mean, even though the government won't put a notice saying that, hey, ladies and gentlemen, do this, go and buy this, go and do that. We as public, we as end users, we must take note of what is happening around us and we must take action accordingly. So here is where, when I look at the posting by Tuan Azizi Ali, so I thought it's a good information that we can share to our audience over here so that we all can appreciate on what is happening and we can take necessary actions. So here is where this effort that we are taking by the public gold team, either from Malaysia, from Singapore, from Brunei, all of us have the same objective because we want to educate as many people as possible to create awareness about this gold savings behavior.
I've read about this statement, inflation is silently robbing you.
Yes.
It's true, it's true.
It's true, exactly. I mean, that is the unfortunate truth. Yeah. It is happening, but then it's just that we cannot do anything about it. And just to give you a local context where I can make my Singaporean friends to appreciate this concept even better, there is a blog written which I read sometime back where they are doing a comparison with on the price of chicken rice across time point. So if we can see the slide over here. In the year early 90s, one plate of chicken rice costed us $1. And then if you see as the time progresses, the price of chicken rice increase, right? So in the year 2018, we can see that the price of chicken rice is $3.50. But then I can also do perhaps a quick survey that let's say if you go to your neighborhood market, if you buy a plate of chicken rice, I do not know whether it's $3.50 enough for you to buy a decent portion of chicken rice or not. Some time back, I bought a plate of chicken rice to Naji. I paid for $4. I thought since I paid $4, I thought it's enough. But then unfortunately, it wasn't enough for me, Tonaji. So I thought, okay.
In fact, my place chicken rice is more than $4.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So we can really see the impact of inflation that is taking place on chicken rice. And using the same concept, it is estimated that in the year 2050, okay, in the year 2060. So $10.60, Tuan Haji, I think, do you think that is a fair price to pay for a plate of chicken rice?
At that time, 2050, maybe, yes. But now, no. But now, if you want to pay $10.60, yes, you can pay at London. Price chicken rice is rough $10.60, $10. Correct. I just heard from someone say, oh, I go London, I buy chicken rice, the price $1 around $10.60. That's true.
Wow.
That will be happen in Singapore, maybe the year that you are talking around 2050.
Yes. So this shows how important we need to take action to protect our long-term savings. And so Tuan Haji, you can go to the next slide. So the next one is just talking about it's just a quick one where we can see how the purchasing power of our money is actually going downwards over the years. So therefore, the money that we save, though we think that we are saving money, but then the value of the money is actually not in our hands. Even though the money itself is in our hands, the value of the money is not in our hands. That is the unfortunate truth. Because as we can see, the purchasing power of the dollar is getting lesser and lesser over the years. And I think that's, we can go to the next slide, Tonaji. So this is where we're going to go to the next, the first topic of the day, where how to profit with gold. That is the question that everybody is asking because they want to know what is the profit potential of gold? Why should I spend the time, spend the effort in saving gold? So first of all, we need to understand what is the mindset that we have in mind what is our mindset when we want to do this gold savings or gold investment? And one of the prominent one, what is the, one of the most common mindset that we all take approach is the gold saver approach. So gold saver, if I can put it in simple terms, is basically we are interested to save money, but then for long term. So when we save money for the long term, that means that we are looking at least 2 years and above. Okay, so 2 years and above, I think is a decent duration, where by keeping at least 2 years and above, you can see a decent return. And so here, the idea here is that the long-term savings that we have in our bank, instead of keeping in the form of cash, we by now we understand why we should not keep our savings in the form of cash, right? So by not keeping in the form of cash, you might be asking, so Naresh, if I don't keep in the form of cash, where can I keep this money, right? So here is where by adopting a gold saver mindset, we can actually convert a portion of our long-term savings in the form of gold, right? So here, some people may ask, if I keep converting my savings into gold, when am I going to appreciate the profit? When am I going to realize the profit? So the answer is, since we are keeping for long-term savings, and at the same time, we are also encouraged to have emergency funds. I think Tuan Haji, Tuan Jalani, Tuan Faizal, they have done a great job in stressing how important having emergency fund is in our financial portfolio. So here, when we use our emergency funds, at one point, perhaps our emergency fund will get lesser and lesser. So that is when we can consider selling off our gold savings, either to top up our emergency fund or use the money for our day-to-day expenses. So to say that buying gold is a one-way journey is not entirely true, because there will be a time where we will sell the gold to manage our expenses. So here is where you can see that I have two price points over here, which I taken from another team in Malaysia, where they are comparing the two price points between 7th of January 2020 versus 7th of January 2022. So you can see that the same 1 gram of gold in January 2020, it was 218 ringgit, right? So 218 ringgit in January 2020, the same 1 gram of gold today, but in 7th January 2022 is worth 264 ringgit. So you can see how, you can see the appreciation that taken place during these 2 years time. So which is why by keeping our long-term savings in the form of gold will be useful because of this appreciation that we will see in the gold price. And as mentioned earlier, when we buy a gold, we must make sure that we receive the gold, right? So this is where choosing the right platform where it offers you the right tool for you to protect your savings is very important. And so here we say that when we convert our long-term savings into gold, slowly but surely our wealth is protected and the value keep increasing. So this is what we mean by gold saver mindset. Tuan Haji, do you have anything you want to add on from this perspective as a gold saver?
Yeah, well, when I look at the price, within 2020 and 2022,
correct.
Today, 7 January, well, that a lot of different the depreciate,
appreciate by a lot.
Appreciate price, the gold price. But if you look at the gold price, goldprice.org, in 20 years,
right.
the increase of gold price is very, very high, you know, more than 500%.
Ah, 500%.
More than 500%. So that's why you are stressed that gold is a long-term saving. It's true. I agree. It's, when we keep gold, it's for long-term, not for the short-term. Not we are buying after 6 months, then we want to sell. That is not the correct mindset.
Correct.
So we have our mindset should be a long term and be patient. Be patient.
Be patient, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, you carry on.
Okay. So yeah, that is the first mindset or first way on how we can profit with gold. Basically by saving, by converting our long-term savings into gold and just keep it for long term until there is a need for you to sell, as what I mentioned earlier, meaning when your emergency fund runs out, or if you hit a particular target. Let's say you want to go for Umrah, for example, you want to go to perform pilgrimage. So for that activity, you might need some expenses. Then you can use your gold savings to fund that activity. But until that happens, our approach is always buy and hold until that happens. So that is the first mindset or the first way on how we can profit with gold. We can go to the next one, Tuan Haji, on the second strategy or the second mindset to adopt. And so here for the second strategy, which is what is known as a gold investor or gold trader. So here is basically the approach is slightly different, even though the tool that being used is also gold. But then the approach or the thinking, the way of thinking is different. So how different, you may ask? The different is that they buy and sell frequently. They buy and sell frequently. And then, so here is where there is, so when they buy and sell frequently, there is an additional work that need to be done. And so these people or the group of gold investor or gold trader, we can call them, they are okay to do this repeatedly because for them, that's what gives them pleasure. They are okay to look at the chart and they are okay to do the analysis, the price action. And then I did some reading about this also. And the tool set or the tool that is being used to do this analysis is known as technical analysis. And technical analysis is basically one way on how we can identify the best buying opportunity and also the best selling opportunity. And this opportunity, we do not know when it will come. Right? We do not know when it will come. It doesn't send us a notification on WhatsApp. Okay, Naresh, today I'm going to drop. You can buy today. And gold price won't send me a notification, won't send notification to Tuan Suliman saying that, hey, Tuan Suliman, today I'm the highest price today. You can consider to sell me. Have you received those kind of notification, Tuan Suliman?
No, Mr. Naresh.
No, actually, right. So
because when you talk about technical analysis, as an investor or trader, uh-huh, you should know also the fundamental analysis, no?
Yes,
technical analysis.
Yes.
Because this factor also can make the price of gold high or low. That's why we have to look at the news. No? If there is any good news, then the gold price will be going up or going down. So we have to really know about technical analysis and fundamental analysis. Yeah.
Exactly. You're absolutely right, Tanaji. So here is where the technical analysis also involves the price action and also understanding the news. So let's say, for example, like if the US economy is doing bad, then the investors of the economy will sell their, will liquidate their positions in the economy, and they will go to the next best asset, which is gold. So they will pump in their money into gold, and that's when the gold price will go up. But then, let's say if the economy is doing well, then the investor will sell off their gold and push back the money into the economy. So it's always it's basically like a tug of war between the economy and also inflation and also the Federal Reserve monetary policies. So if these traders are okay to go through all this hassle of understanding the news and they use all the technical jargons, they will mention something about unemployment rate, they will speak about the CPI, the consumer price index. So if you understand all that, then you can consider adopting this mindset. And also you must do the extra work by doing the analysis on the price action. So Tuan Haji, actually I also did do some reading on understanding this price action, but yeah. I don't think so. My mindset can adopt that. I try to understand they call it the moving averages lah, and then they have the so many, there are so many indicators lah, Tuan Haji.
I also
don't know which one to use. And it's you put everything also, you won't see the price. You will only see the indicators only. So,
yeah. Like Cik Suko told me, if you want to do trading or investor, you must have two heart, you know.
Yeah.
Because sometimes when the price of gold drop, then your heart also might be dropped.
Yeah, absolutely right. Exactly. So I think here is where I think Mr. Shufaat is also one person that Tuan Shukur has recommended. So that is why I put over here. So people, so the audience, ladies and gentlemen, if you're interested to know more about how to understand the technical analysis from gold perspective, you can consider visiting the website to get more information. But though it may sound easy on theory, because people will say, when to buy, we buy when the price is low. When to sell, you sell when the price is high. Of course, it's easy to say like this. But then the question is, how low is low and how high is high? That is the tricky part, don't you think, Tuan Haji?
Yes. That's why for us, if we are become a gold saver, that is the most safest. And the important thing when you buy or when you invest, you can sleep well at night. That is very important. So
exactly.
If you always suddenly wake up because the gold price is going up, going down, that is not for you. It's not for you. So you must have a strong heart.
Must have a strong heart. Okay, that is very true. Yes.
Yeah.
So we need to do constant monitoring in order to understand the price action and to make the necessary changes. So if you are okay to do this kind of activities, then perhaps you can adopt this gold investor or gold trader mindset. Okay, so that is the second way on how we can profit with gold. We can go to the next one, Tuan Haji.
Okay.
So the third one is also another interesting way, because here the fundamental concept here is that we want to save for long term, but at the same time we are running this as a business. Okay, we are running this as a business where so now like Tuan Haji and myself, Tuan Jailani, we all took the trouble to read from books, to attend seminar. We listen to courses, and then we understand the fundamental concepts of gold saving. And after we understand the fundamental gold saving, the next thing what we did, we took action, right? We took action. We started small by putting maybe 100 ringgit, $100, and then we started buying 1 gram, 10 gram, 100 gram, right? And then and so now as we do this for years, we saw our wealth is actually being protected. We saw our savings is being protected. So it's a good news, right, Tuan Haji? When we work so hard for our money and then we convert our savings into gold and we see our savings is protected when we save in the form of gold, we feel very happy. Right,
yes.
Tuan Haji?
Yeah. Agree. That's why I consistently with public gold, because I start public gold since 2012.
Almost
10 years.
Yeah.
If I can save every year 100 gram, you can calculate that.
Yeah, exactly. So now that we all have experienced the appreciation, we saw how useful gold is helping in our financial portfolio. The easiest thing we can do is to keep it to ourselves and just go along. We just keep it to ourselves because we already received the benefits. We can just keep it to ourselves and then just continue with our daily life. But what we did is that we take another step. We take another step whereby we wanted to share this to more people. We wanted to share this to more people so that the benefit that we receive is also can also be experienced by so many people out there. So here is where by being a gold dealer, by a trusted platform, not simply by any random company, but you must choose a trusted platform where they provide you this opportunity where you save gold for yourself. And at the same time, when you share these benefits to people around you, your friends, your family, or anybody who are interested to learn, so they also can adopt the same mindset, and they also can start this journey together with all of us. And in order to achieve that, the third mindset or the third approach that we can take on is the being a goal dealer. So yeah. In simple terms, what does it mean being a goal dealer? A goal dealer means we just basically share the benefits of goal saving to our friends and family. So maybe some of them need more time to think about it, but some of them are already thinking about where to start, where to buy. And once they see you doing it, because they trust you, right? They look at you and they look, oh, Tuan Haji is doing this. Oh, Tuan Jalani is doing this. So why don't I ask them? Let me drop them a message and ask them, what is it all about? Right? So they will contact you, and then you explain to them. And then you also show how goal actually give you a positive impact in your life. So when we do that, and then we are encouraging more people to come on board. When they come on board, they also protect their savings, and all of us will benefit from this program. And by doing so, we are getting a small reward from Public Gold. So in this case, we're talking about Public Gold. And by running this as a business, we share this benefit to more people. And when people come on board along with us, we will get a small a commission. So here we call it commission or incentive. It's like a royalty. It's like a royalty because we encourage people to come on board. And this royalty is not something that... So people will say, oh, since it's a royalty, therefore, is it a pyramid scheme? Do I also have to recruit people when I join? The answer is no, right? Here, you come on board, you only do for yourself as a goal saver. That is what the mindset that we are sharing to people around us. You come on board as a goal saver, you start small, 1 gram per month or 1 dinar per month, and then you experience yourself how the goal is helping you. Okay, so whether or not you want to bring more people under you, that is a different story, because when you do that, you are actually taking the third approach that we are sharing just now. So for now, you come on board as a goal saver, you experience how goal is giving you a positive impact. Okay, so Tuan Haji, maybe something that you want to add over here?
Yeah, you have explained very long, detailed and complete. It's already 45 minutes. Yeah. Maybe order like, you know, okay, the way you explain is very good. I want to join. So how can I join Public Gold? I think that is another topic that people like to know, right?
Yes, so, exactly.
So to summarize what you are talking, three topics. Be a goal saver. Be a goal trader.
Goal trader.
Or investor. And the thirdly, be a goal dealer.
Correct, goal dealer, yes.
So let us, your goal dealer. And correct. In fact, in Public Gold, there are so many goal dealers still working, and they are earning, they are getting more income from Public Gold compared to their the main income.
Yeah.
So this is very important. That's why if you know the secret, that's why up to now, I'm still doing Public Gold. Okay, so can I continue?
Please.
Left only 15 minutes for me.
Yeah, time flies when you are sharing good things.
Yeah, okay. Okay, this is our vision and mission to educate and keep at least 100 grams pure gold for each individual and to have 1 kilo for family. Mr. Nariz, if yep. every year we can keep 100 grams, then uh-huh. if 5 years is already 500 grams.
Yep.
Yeah. If 10 years is already 1 kilo, kg. You know?
Yeah, exactly. So yeah. people when they hear at one glance, right, 1 kg is like, wow, this is a lot. But actually, if we do slowly, consistently, like what Tuan Haji mentioned, patiently, that is the most important one.
Yeah.
So we can achieve it. I'm very confident that each and every one of us will achieve this. So the secret is only by adopting one mindset out of the three mindset that we saw earlier, either as goal saver or goal trader or goal dealer. So by adopting one of these three mindset or the strategy, we can all achieve this, the ultimate goal, which is achieving 1 kg for each family. It's not impossible, dear friends.
Yeah.
Just give a try and you will see how easy it is.
So, last week, last Saturday topic Azam 2022. We are stressing about reserve, gold reserve.
Ah, so right.
if every country like Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, they have their own reserve, gold is one of the portfolio.
Correct.
Why don't we have that kind of reserve?
Exactly. Yeah. If the governments around the world is also doing it, we as end user also must have it.
That's why we should put the mindset on that. To everyone today listening to our webinar, okay, I must have 1 kilo for our family. Yeah, agree, Mr. Narin?
Yes, I totally agree. I would wish all the audiences the very best in achieving this dream.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, Sandra Grace Sheila. Hi all, attending from Kota Kinabalu, Sabah.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, Sandra. Thank you for supporting us. Okay. Of course, we will give more info and more tips about how to protect our wealth. That is very important. Okay, Mr. Naris, maybe we can wrap up.
Yes, we can wrap up, Tuan Haji. So let me begin by thanking Tuan Haji for this opportunity once again, and also to ladies and gentlemen for joining us today. And the intention of us doing this is because we want to create more awareness so that the benefits that myself and Tuan Haji has seen, has benefited, we want to share to more people. That is why we are doing this. So the first thing you need to invest is in yourself by getting the books, get the relevant knowledge. You can contact either Tuan Haji or myself. We can actually help you to get the books. Maybe you are not confident in doing this yet, but then getting the knowledge is always good, all right?
Correct.
So get the knowledge, and then slowly you will build this momentum in gold saving. And one day with gold, we will all achieve ultimate financial freedom. So with that, thank you so much for your attention. And again, Tuan Haji, I pass back to you with my sincere gratitude in giving me this opportunity.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Naris. Next week will be another person with different topic. Every week we are giving very interesting topic for us to learn about goal saving, about goal, especially about goal. So until then, thank you so much for supporting us every week, all the audience, ladies and gentlemen. So till we'll meet again next Saturday. Until then, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and good afternoon.
Thank you so much.